Painting is one of the most popular pastimes on the planet, and easily one of the oldest. But have you ever stopped and wondered how paint is actually made?
Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Humans have been using paints for a long time. Some of the oldest art ever found are cave paintings that are more than 44,000 years old. Our cave ancestors were scribbling their work on the walls with red and black pigment that came from whatever they could find that would leave behind colors. Rocks, charcoal, berries, or different minerals found in the soil. The earliest prehistoric cave paintings look like something you might find in a modern elementary school. It's a collage of hands stenciled onto the wall. Paint has changed plenty since we first lived in caves. People eventually discovered more colorful rocks, clays, and minerals in the earth and developed new ways to mine them and turn those raw rocks into powdery pigments. Paints of just about every color were available in the ancient world, and they were slapped on everything. Armor, artwork, statues, murals, and buildings were all painted, making ancient Rome much more colorful than we imagine. Some colors were hard to make, and that made them highly valuable. Take Tyrian purple, for example. That's a reddish purple hue made from sea snails that was all the rage in the Roman world. The purple dye was made in the city of Tyre in modern-day Lebanon. No one knows exactly how it was made, but we do have a few stinky details. Tens of thousands of sea snails were collected in nets and left out to decompose in the sun, which didn't smell great. Besides the smell, it also apparently took lots of labor to turn the rotting snails into a purple dye. All of this work made the dye expensive and a way for someone to show just how rich they were. For centuries, paints remained popular, but were too expensive for common people to buy since it wasn't so easy to make them. But that all started to change around the time of the Industrial Revolution. New technologies made paint faster, easier, and much cheaper to produce. And by the late 1800s, the average person could walk into a store and buy paint at an affordable price in just about any color they wanted. Today, most paints are made using three main ingredients: a pigment, a resin, and a solvent. Pigments give paint its color, and resin helps the pigments stick together and fuse to the surface you're painting. The solvent is usually water or oil, and it helps keep the paint wet so clumps don't form and it goes on evenly. So next time you smell the stink of wet paint drying on a wall, at least you can take comfort in the fact that it doesn't smell as bad as 10,000 rotting sea snails. Ugh, and that's progress.